Not that guy, pal. Trust me. You're not that guy.
This should be a fun little episode because, you know, I got a PhD. I mean, I could have had a PhD if I kept on going with college, but, you know, college for losers or smart people or people that make money. Yeah. Anyway, time to react to Find the Real Doctor by Jubilee.
Good evening, it's Jason and Jada, the director of this video.
We just want to give a quick shout out to our sponsors, Janu.
Janu?
The ones that provided the awesome scrubs that our doctors are wearing and the ones that we currently have on right now.
Honestly, my parents always wanted me to be a doctor growing up. That never really happened. But had I known that you could wear comfortable scrubs like this every day, I would honestly reconsider.
Be sure to stick around to see how you can get your first pair of Janu scrubs.
Are you basically a doctor?
But until then, enjoy the video.
When you guys were on call, what was your least favorite thing to be woken up by?
I got a little bit annoyed with the Tylenol call, but, you know, I had to do what I had to do, so.
I did have to see a patient for, like, herpes in his eye, so that wasn't very pleasant.
Herpes in his eyes? Did he get... How do you get herpes in your eyes? In your eyes, how do you do that? That's a new one.
I am a doctor.
Five are posers.
Okay.
One is the real deal.
So there's one real
in
doctor and five
liars,
fake.
Can these teams find the real deal?
The real deal.
So, how are we
this
doing?
Is actually my first time watching these type of videos.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I feel like maybe a little more confident than I should be now that I get a look at you.
Mm-hmm. They ain't ready. Okay. Numbers 1 through 6.
Oh, so those are nurses order. And those are like regular people.
Specialties and what school you went to?
I'm a dermatologist and I went to UCI.
I'm a urologist and I went to University of Tennessee.
Mm. I'm an emergency doctor and I went to UCF as well.
Physical therapist, Rutgers University.
I'm a pediatrician.
Physical therapist. I feel like out of all the doctors, it's kind of like the dentist of the doctors. Like, you do some good work, but you know.
And I went to Drexel University.
I'm an optometrist and I went to Southern California College.
Oh, I kind of believe her.
Number six,
she seems
can
more
you
stern.
Tell me what 2020 vision means.
Yeah, so basically it's kind of complicated. There's a lot of like physics to it, but there's a certain angle that's subtended by the letters that are on the Snellen chart that you're looking at. And so they standardize that at 20.
Okay, after her, she's talking. She doesn't strike me anymore. I'll take back my saying.
20 feet distance. So if you're 20/20, you're seeing what someone should be seeing at 20 feet. But if you're 20/30, what someone can see at 30 feet, you need to be standing at 20 feet in order to see.
When you guys were on call, what was your least favorite thing to be woken up by?
During my residency, I actually had a case of...
What's dermatologist? Anybody know what that is? Is that something to do with the mouth? No, dermatologist. That's something to do with the anus. That's what it is.
And Johnson's, and that was very scary to
face.
See.
A large accident.
Same thing.
With fatalities, is always a grim scene to come in.
I just don't buy him as a doctor. I just like his accent is giving me that Leslie Jones vibes.
Into especially if.
How y'all doing?
The worst.
Nothing.
Thing
I've
ever
shit.
Had.
I got a little bit annoyed with the Tylenol call, but. You know, I had to do what I had to do, so.
My emergencies are mainly during like a practice or a
I can kind of see him as
I've
a physical therapy
that
doctor.
Be, like lower the inflammation and put ice packs or certain, you know, massage therapy.
I think just seeing any babies in pain and then seeing like a tragic loss is the hardest thing.
I haven't been on call as much, honestly, but I did have to see a patient for like herpes in his eye, so
there
that isn't very pleasant.
I think you'd be thinking.
I'm never thinking what I'm thinking.
Oh, I'm thinking what you're thinking. Okay.
What are we thinking?
Making an elimination.
Oh.
Each team will try to find the real deal by eliminating the imposters.
Okay.
If both teams eliminate the same person, they will be removed from the game.
When you ask about why they don't like being called at night, you know, it's so sad and the children and this like general thing. I was like, okay, that's nice, but
How long have you been practicing since, well, you're still in residency. So since out of residency?
I have been out of residency for a little over a year.
Oh.
I graduated in 1993 and went right into work.
Sir, you look at least 70. You graduated in 90, no, you graduated in 19, like 70. I think he's a fake one.
28.
I graduated medical school in 2021.
I've been practicing for 15 years.
I finished my residency at USC Medical Center 5 years ago.
and I've been out of school for 1 year.
Doctor number one, I have a question. For the medical terminology, intra versus inter, since you're a dermatologist, what's the difference?
Yeah, so that much later.
Since I've been in medical terminology, but I definitely use inter a lot, and that would be inside. And then intra, gosh, I don't remember off the top of my head.
Doctor number four, can you name me the different kinds of cruciate?
I've seen her before. I've seen her in something on a different YouTube channel, but I don't know what it is.
Ligaments?
Three? You said three?
However many there are.
Oh, we got the anterior, interior. Oh, you have a meniscus. Those are the main for knee.
Gotcha. Doctor number three.
That was awkward.
What system is the lymph nodes a part of?
The what?
Lymphatic system.
I don't
know. Are we allowed to eliminate two?
No, just one.
Okay. Nice. Ready.
It's that emo hair.
As a reminder, that Sasuke haircut. If both teams eliminate the same person, that person will be removed from the game.
When I asked him to name me the cruciate ligaments, and he answered with
meniscus,
which is not a cruciate ligament, as a physical.
What is this? What is this? What do you mean, medical drama fans? These are people that watch Grey's Anatomy? You probably can't see, you can't see it because I'm in the way. You can't see it. Right there. Medical drama fans. I feel like they're not qualified.
Physical therapist. You should probably know that.
Doctor number five, could you tell me a common medication that you prescribe for one of your patients?
Benevate, it's for babies that have phimosis before they get circumcised. We try that method first.
I think she might be the real doctor. I don't know.
Doctor number five, I had a question for you too. For a baby under 28 days, if they had a fever, how much Motrin would you give them?
Ideally none.
Ooh, she knows her stuff. Okay, go ahead.
Doctor number six, if a patient had glaucoma, what kind of prescription would you give them?
You give them weed. Weed fix everything. Got glaucoma in the eye, you give them weed.
Called latanoprost, so it's an eye drop. You'd use that one at nighttime only, in whichever I had the glaucoma.
And then what would be the abbreviation for nighttime only?
QHS.
Our resident, number three.
This also can be people that's currently in med school too, so they can know some stuff.
Can you tell me what a normal blood pressure is and then kind of explain to me what those numbers mean?
120 over 80 and 120 is the systolic, so pretty much the amount of blood that's in the chamber before it's ejected, and then the bottom number is basically the resting volume.
1 and 4. Could you tell me what kind of cars you guys drive?
I drive a Toyota Honda Highlander.
So I have been driving the same car since I was 15. I drive a Honda CR-V. I am still paying off medical school, so I will be driving that until it cannot be driven anymore.
I think we're ready to make another elimination.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Who we deciding to eliminate? Four? Damn.
In this round, both teams have decided that one person is definitely not the real deal. Number four.
I feel like he's a trainer.
I'll miss you.
He's just so damn big.
I would love to hear your wackiest story from a patient on the job. Down the line, sorry, I'd love to hear from all of you.
So we had a TikTok star in one time, and when I entered the room, he was standing on the medical bed filming something, pretending he was surfing. So that was definitely very interesting.
Was he a lunatic?
It was a vaginal occlusion.
The way he talks, it just seems like he's like somebody's gay uncle or grandfather. How y'all doing? Today, my bedazzlers, I got something special for you. Like, it's just, I don't know.
And her friend had been playing around with a bottle and created a vacuum, therefore lodging the bottle in her vagina.
I had this elderly patient. She had some sundowning, some form of dementia, but she kept asking me to go to the bathroom with her to show her a good time.
A mother asked me, is it okay to put false eyelashes on her newborn baby?
That baby was black. That was a black baby. If this is true, that was a black baby.
Pictures.
For me, I had a guy come in because he was playing with a Nerf gun, and then I guess he got hit in the eye, and then he ended up having like traumatic uveitis, and then he got some glaucoma as a result from that.
Damn.
So that was pretty crazy.
Nerf or nothing, right?
Yeah. All right, we're good to eliminate.
We eliminated him. I figured he doesn't seem
two.
Sorry, sir.
He seemed like an actor.
So we eliminated number two next because there were very broad answers given. It wasn't very like specific to what a urologist actually does.
So this is a question for Dr.
Again, they only watch Grey's Anatomy, so they don't really know shit.
It's 3 and 5. You walk into the room and you see the patient's monitor, me, flatline.
Uh-oh.
You feel their pulse, there's nothing there. How many joules are you going to shock them with?
Oh,
Dr. number 5.
I actually don't know this.
Five. Dr. number 3. 200.
Dr. 1.
It has been a while since I've been in the ER. I am a dermatologist after all, but if I remember correctly, it's 150 joules.
Okay, and Dr. 6.
Yeah, so I definitely don't work in the emergency room, so I don't really work with that. I'm not sure.
That's fair.
Okay. That was a question everyone got wrong. The answer is none, because you don't shock asystole. But that's something medical TV sometimes gets wrong. Everybody comes in there with the paddles ready to go.
Oh.
Like, I don't know. I don't know who's...
I don't know anything.
So if they're flatlining, you just watch? What do you do? You're like, he's going to come back to life. Just give it a moment. Like, I don't... What do you do?
Real deal at this point.
Well, the lady said she's not sure, so she doesn't really know. So, I mean, for like an eye doctor, you don't really... I don't feel like you don't really need to know that. So because of that, I want to say, I think these two, I think they're more likely to be doctors, but something about her face just screams like, I don't know. She just looked like she could be a doctor. That emo haircut, nah, bro. You like 20 years old. You're not a doctor. I don't know who to pick, guys. I don't know who to pick. I mean, we haven't made the final choice yet. Really?
Okay, I have a...
Wait, but he said 200 and she said 150. She said 5. That's closer to 0. Why would you eliminate her and not one of them?
Question for Dr. Number
3. Is it because she's black? I'm just playing. I'm just
3. So earlier I asked you what system the lymph nodes are a part of. You said the lymphatic system. What's the major system that it's a part of?
I know that it recycles like dead cells, fights off infections and whatnot. I'm just like at the tip of my head. I'm just like nervous right now, so I can't.
Dr. Number 1, really, do you know what the answer is?
I believe it's the circulatory system.
Dr. Number 6, do you agree?
The immune system.
Sweet. Like, okay.
Dr. Number 5, what is the average heartbeat of a newborn versus a 1-year-old?
Ooh.
For a newborn, it's lower, so maybe like 35 beats per minute. It elevates by the time they're 1, obviously. So maybe like 40, 30, 45.
Okay, right. I'm ready to make an elimination.
I'm ready too, yeah.
Okay.
How much medical debt?
Doctor number 5.
Thank you.
Thank you. She talked about the heartbeat for a baby. That gave it away.
She answered that a resting heart rate of a fetus or infant is 35, which it'd be very concerning if it was that. They'd be not alive.
Okay, I think we're gonna have
really
a demonstration. I was just gonna have
you said Dr. 5 is fine. Oh, she was
eye exam with my pen light on Andre.
Okay,
and tell us what she's looking for.
Let's see what Dr. number 6 got. Is she a pro or not?
See those skills in action.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I think it might be her.
We're checking to see if your pupils are equally responsive to light and if they are equal in terms of size.
Ooh.
I'm going to do the direct response first. So just look straight ahead for me, please.
Go ahead. Do your thing, doctor. What's her name? I want to say Chan, but I feel that's racist.
Cool. So when I shine it between the two eyes, I'm looking to see if the other one stays constricted, because that means that there's like a good communication between like the brain. So that's what I'm looking for.
I think so, but when you're like a baby, isn't your heartbeat faster, or am I wrong? Or is it slower? I'm not entirely sure.
Doctor number one, can you tell me what medication you typically prescribe to patients with cystic acne?
Yes, so if the acne is bad enough, we're gonna put them on Accutane. But that is a high-risk drug, so we have to make sure that the women come in every month and give us a pregnancy test. And then I also recommend to not drink very much when you're on that
medication. I wonder if they already eliminated the doctor, the real one.
Last thing, does a bar of soap clean the face pretty well?
It can, yes. I have some patients that don't even use soap when they wash their face.
I was told you're not supposed to put soap on your face, that it can mess. Are you supposed to put soap on your face? I thought you use other like cleaning things to wash your face. I was always told that you just use water and then you use like, you know, the moisturizers to wash your face.
And they have beautiful skin, so it kind of just depends on your physiology.
Thank you.
Oh, they do have soap that's for your face? I did not know that. I was told that like you never want to wash your face with soap because it can like break your skin out too. Okay, who do I think it is? I low-key, if it's not six, then it's five. I don't think it's them. Cause I feel like she's in school for to be a doctor, but she's not actually a doctor. He's like an actor or something. If it's not her, then it was definitely five.
Doctor number six. What is that machine called that blows air into your eye?
Yeah, so that's called it's a non-contact tonometer. It measures your eye pressure.
Also, I feel like she was my doctor before. I feel like I've seen her before. Is that a little racist?
To screen for conditions like glaucoma.
The cones that are in our eye, what do they do?
So they help you perceive color.
Mm-hmm.
What colors do we see?
Okay, sorry, I'm trying to think.
What colors do we see? Well, technically, isn't it like you see three colors, but the way, I don't know. I don't even know that. That's a weird question.
Red, green, and yellow.
Doctor number three, talk me through intubating someone. What are you trying not to accidentally push it down instead?
You're not trying to push down the tongue so that they don't like, or it doesn't block the airway.
Okay. I'm gonna ask one more question real quick. So doctor number one, somebody has a mole. They want to get it checked out. What are some things they should look out for?
So changes in shape, color, if there's any pain, that's definitely something we want to know. And then
exactly, so stuff like that you forget. Like that's not super important. Like why would a doctor need to know like what color you see in the eyes? Like they just try to make sure that you can see. They don't care about the colors. Like
want to look at as well.
That is all I needed. One of you is a real doctor. The other five of you are going to jail for impersonating a doctor.
I feel like they're going to get it wrong because they watch too much Grey's Anatomy. I'm going to go six. If it's not six, it's five.
Those doctors look really nice, Jason.
They really do.
What is this?
When Dr. Neela, co-founder of Janu, put on her first pair of scrubs, she felt deflated.
Is it sponsored?
The boxy, baggy fit really did not inspire her to perform at her best. And that's why she created Janu, to help ensure that healthcare professionals everywhere achieve their greatness with comfortable scrubs that allow for peak performance.
Their breathable antimicrobial fabrics are wrinkle-free, moisture-wicking, and allow you to be active and move with zero distractions. Janu believes that better care has the power to provide a better world. So join them and reimagine your own greatness.
That's right. And today, for 15% off your first pair of scrubs, you can visit janu.com and use the code Jubilee15 at checkout. Now enjoy the rest of the video.
Okay.
We think the real
deal. Do they think everybody that watched the show is like nurses and doctors? I'm an average Joe.
Is doctor number one.
Dermatologist. We think she was knowledgeable about everything that she explained. She didn't really know the jewels, but like she said, she's not in the ER very often.
We think the real deal is doctor number one. She didn't follow any of her answers.
I think it's
and
six.
The more that she kind of got into it, the more I felt that like she was a doctor talking to
me. Also, I feel like skincare, a lot of people know about skincare without being a doctor too. Like I feel like that's something that's kind of knowledgeable.
Patient.
I think
in
it's
the
six.
Event that both teams lock in the real deal, the team that locked in their guess first wins.
If the lights on the floor turn green, that means that you have chosen the real deal. If they turn red, that means that you have
chosen the impossible. It might be one. I think it's six, but
the real deal will be revealed in three,
two,
two,
uno,
one.
Oh.
What the?
If it's six,
Hello,
you
teams.
Owe me
my name
money.
Is Rebecca. I am not a doctor. I was in the medical field. My original plan was to be a PA, but then I left medicine. I went and got my MBA, and now I'm in marketing. I started working in healthcare 4 years ago, so it was a bit of a memory kind of situation. I was an MA for dermatology and plastic surgery, private office.
Because you are not able to find the real deal, we will reveal them to you.
What did I say? What did I say? Hold up, nope. Give me my music, Hold up, no. I told you. Hold up. Where is it? I've been listening to this on TikTok. Hold up. I don't know what y'all saying because I can't see the chat, but I know y'all be like, God damn, he's so smart and sexy. How did he do that? Hold up. Where is he? Where the music? I can't get in this chair because I'll break it. You can't really see me because the camera. Hold up. I just heard the pop. Hold up. Something just pop. I knew it. She, like, I don't know. Like, it was something about her, like, whole posture. Like, she seemed like a doctor that I've actually seen before when I went to the eye doctor.
Yeah,
I would have won.
She was right there.
I should have gone off the cones.
I would have won.
Hi, I'm Nicole, and I'm the real doctor.
Yeah.
I think sometimes maybe the way I speak can come off a little ditzy. I don't know if it's just my own persona of myself,
but
I feel like some people don't really look at me and assume that I could be a doctor.
Oh, I
think that Dr. Number One did an amazing job. Like, I literally would go to her.
She either was in the medical field or she used to be a doctor or something like that. They definitely gave us a run for our money.
We had a good time.
I'm still bitter.
See? And they going based off Grey's Anatomy. Like, come on now. I knew I was right. It was something about her that just oozed, like, magnificent. You know what I'm saying?